Dear students, I welcome you in this series of online classes. Today we are going to study a song from As You Like It, and namely that is prescribed in your book Under the Greenwood Tree, and that is written by great writer, dramatist and tragedy writer William Shakespeare. We are going to read about Under the Greenwood Tree, a song that is given in As You Like It play. That basically As You Like It is a comedy, and this song is uttered by a duke and who was exiled by his brother because of certain interests. He was exiled, and the whole poem is all about the pleasures of nature, advantages of foresters. In this poem, Shakespeare has made us understand the pleasures and advantages of nature, is staying closer to nature. So before starting our lesson, it is better to understand about the writer, about the creator. And the writer is William Shakespeare. He was a great dramatist. He was born in 1564 and died 1660. He enjoys unparalleled position in English literature. Basically, he is better known as a dramatist of Elizabethan era. And he enjoys same position as in our saint, the great saint, Sufi poet, Shah Abdul Latif enjoys. Shakespeare is very much famous for because of his comprehensive soul. It is said that he was not only limited to England, but he is a writer, writer and dramatist of all ages. He had most comprehensive soul, and up to now, Shakespeare's great qualities is universality. This was the short introduction about the writer. So now let's start the reading of a song. Basically, it is a song, and it is not to be read, but it is to be sung. So in this song, we have divided the song in two stanzas. Every stanza has six lines, and in these six lines, rhyming scheme is six line stanza where every couplet rhyme each other. The poem reads under the greenwood tree, who loves to lie with me. The poet invites readers, invites our youth to come and enjoy the pleasures of nature. He has suggested ways that nature is not cruel. We must spend some time in the lap of nature, because nature endures us, gives us benefits. Once the king was, when he was exiled and he had no place, he was devoid of pleasures of city life, he thought that it is better to reign, to live in forests, because in forests there is no pollution, in forests there is no fear of enemies, in forests there is no fear of dethronement, in forests there is no fear of attack, no fear of cruelty. And once he was deposed from his throne, he thought the only thing that gives me a pleasure, and the only thing that accepts me with or welcomes me, that is nature, that is the world of forests. In this forest, the writer, the duke, says a song. So the song goes like this: under the greenwood tree, who loves to lie with me, is there anyone who want to stay with me closer and want to enjoy the pleasures of nature in along with me, and turn his merry note unto the sweet bird's thrill. And he wants to invite us to see and hear the melodious sounds of birds, and he wants to make us realize how beautiful birds sing, how beautifully and melodious voice they are presenting. He invites us that we must sing such melodious songs. He invites readers, he invites us that we should sing songs that must be melodious like that of birds. Come hither, he invites us. He says, come closer to me, and here shall he see no enemy but winter and rough weather. In the nature, there is no fear of enemies. In the nature, there is no fear of troubles. There is no fear of dethronement. There is no fear of attack outside from others. There is no fear of only the thing that rules in the nature, in the forest, is that is rough weather, that attracts us, that is source of ultimate source of inspiration for many of us, and that was the ultimate source of inspiration for the person duke, who was exiled, who was deprived of his material and benefits of city life. Whereas the next stanza is about surrendering our wishes, surrendering our aspirations, worldly aspirations. And he, in next stanza, the writer says, who doth ambitious shun? Is there anyone who can sacrifice his worldly ambitions and loves to lie in the sun and want to stay in the sun, where there is a possibility of rough weather, there is a possibility of warmth, and loves to seeking the food he is. And he must be contented, whatever nature provides him, whatever he gets. He should not strive beyond his limited resources. Whatever nature has bestowed upon him, he is happy, he is contented with that, and pleased with what he gets. And he is contented. Come hither. Here there is a repetition of that line that is given in first stanza. Here shall he see no enemy, but winter and rough weather. Here Shakespeare again tells us that there is only one possibility of nature. That nature, to some critics it may be cruel, but in nature there is a possibility of natural threats. Except those threats, there is no possibility of fear, there is no possibility of dethronement, there is no possibility of outside attack, only rough weather. Yes, Shakespeare familiarizes us the one great danger of a nature, that is only rough weather. That there are few people who have courage to sustain the dangers of nature, but on the contrary, we in our society, in our communities, we have multiple challenges. So Shakespeare has acquainted us with great challenges of society, and he has compared the society in this little piece of song. He has given us advantages and disadvantages of foresters. In forest life, we have every sort of advantage except one challenge, dangers of nature, dangers of rough weather.